Fallout 3.
Broken Steel.
Rebel Link. This is video 3.
Alright, so what we're going to be doing is making our way through this building and taking out a bunch of these soldiers to retrieve some data that we're going to take back to the Citadel for analysis. It's pretty self-explanatory, really easy, so there's not really much explaining to do in this level. So, what I'm going to do is just address some quick things about Broken Steel. In the previous video, I called the new Super Mutant Colossus. That's not their name. They're actually called Overlords. Super Mutant Overlords. And to give you an idea of what their damage resistance is, these three new type of enemies that you're going to be facing quite frequently in the Wasteland. For example, the Super Mutant Master, which is considered the toughest Super Mutant, has a 360 health point or damage resistance. Health point, whatever you want to call it. Super Mutant Overlord has 1250 damage resistance, practically four times. That's how hard those bad boys are to take out. The Feral Ghoul Reaver, the new one that you're going to see, is 1100. And the Albino Rat Scorpion you're going to see in the Wasteland is 1500. So again, you're definitely going to want to take advantage of that Goss Fox combo, and that will help a ton of taking those enemies out in pretty quick fashion. Alright, had a couple questions I saw in the comments that I wanted to address here. One was from Buddy Weems. He had a question about does the Ghoul Mask work on the new ghouls? And the answer to the question is yes. I probably won't be using it in this video, but yeah, if you do want to avoid those guys, definitely carry a new ghoul mask with you. If you're not familiar with the ghoul mask is, if you go to Tenpenny Towers, there is a side quest there. There's a good karma, bad karma side quest, and I believe a neutral karma. But anyways, if you go the bad karma route and decide to side with the ghouls and let them into a Tenpenny Tower and let them overrun it, their leader will give you a ghoul mask to wear so the ghouls don't attack you. And, so if you're going to be, if you want to avoid those bad boys, make sure and get that mask, and then that's one enemy you don't have to worry about. Okay, so other question was from YouTube90. He asked, he lost Sharon and Star Paladin after the American Dream. He wanted to know where to go get him. Alright, if you're playing that level, you just got the Gek, and the Enclave throw those concussion grenades and then, you know, they take you away to their base. So, if you have any followers up until that point, guess what? They're still there. Now I would say probably there's a 90% chance they're still there. I've seen through forums and whatnot that they thought they were there and they disappeared. In fact, in this game, I've had a follower just disappear completely. And that was after I went to go get, where you go get your dad. I took Sharon with me inside that building and got into the egg to go into to do the Tranquility Lane quest, and I got out of the egg and he had vanished, and he wasn't even back at the Ghoul City. So that kind of happened to me. But what happens in this game, if you tell your companion to wait, and the game goes longer than 7 days, 7 days in the game, then they'll go back to wherever they usually can be found. So, for example, Sharon goes back to Ghoul City, aka the History Museum. Fox also goes to the same place, Ghoul City. Dogmeat goes actually to the very first vault you come out of, the main vault, And those are the ones I know just off the top of my head. But in the wiki guide, it'll tell you exactly where each one goes back to. Just look it up if you have a different follower besides those three. Alright, in the event that they're not there, you're fortunately going to have to just hopefully save prior to that. And the thing to do before you enter any of those scenarios is to have them wait. Or send them, or fire them, or send them on their way. Because if you fire Sharon, for example, all he does is go back to Ghoul City. Okay? So, that way you don't have to wait the 7 days for him to go back. Or travel back all the way down through there. Just back to that particular vault to see if he's there. So, the other thing, if you have the dual followers too, and you send them back and you go and try and get them again, it is really hard to get the dual followers because immediately they're going to recognize you have somebody with you and they may not participate. I know there's a workaround for that in the wiki guide, so again, just type in or Google Fallout 3 wiki and there'll be something there, or you know, the website will be right there for you guys to use. Alright, so this is the end of this video. We're going to be going back, trekking back to Citadel to have the data analyzed. And then we're going to do another yapping mission where we got to talk to a bunch of freaking people. Alright, so you see you guys there.